Next one. There are certain plane figures on the screen. Pairs of figures you can see. This is a trapezium. This is another trapezium. And here is a hexagon. No, not a hexagon. A pentagon. Two pentagons, two circles, and two arrow marks. All these are same in all respects except the size. Size is varying. So two plane figures which are of the same shape are called, but different in size, are called similar figures, right? So these are all called similar figures. So these two arrow marks are similar, these two circles are similar. For that matter, any two circles are similar, any two squares are similar. Okay, now we'll go back to next one. These are all similar figures, you understand that. Now here you see the similarity of two polygons. These two polygons are of same number of sides, four sides, four sides, ABCD, PQRS. Okay, now you can see the angles, angle A equal to angle P, angle D equal to angle B equal to angle Q, C equal to R, 70 degrees, S and D equal to 85 degrees each. And if you compare the sides here, any two corresponding sides you take, they are in the same ratio. 1.5 is to 3, it is 2. Similarly, 2.1 is to 4.2, that is also 2. Here also 2, here also 2. So they are all of the same, they are all of the same ratio, they are proportional. The corresponding sides are proportional and the corresponding angles are equal. This is what is important for two similar figures. Two polygons of the same number of sides are similar if all the corresponding angles are equal and all the corresponding sides are in the same ratio or in proportion. Did you understand the meaning of similarity?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, yes, sir.
Now we will.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Next one. See, here we have two figures here, two plane figures. Whether they are similar or not, we will decide. Here you see the all the corresponding angles ABCD are correspondingly equal to PQRS. All are right angles. But if you see AB, ratio between AB and PQ, it is 3 is to 3.5, whereas BC is to RQ is 3 is to 3. So the ratios are different here. Ratios of corresponding sides are not equal. These two, ratio of these two is not equal to ratio of these two. Is it not? So here in this figure, in the above figures, the corresponding angles are equal, but the corresponding sides are not in the same ratio. So we say they are not similar. They are not similar at all. It is a square, whereas this is a rectangle. Square and rectangle are not similar. Next, here we observe these two figures. The corresponding sides are not in the same ratio there now in the previous one. Here you check 2.1 and 4.2. 2.1 is to 4.2, it is 2. 1 is to 2. And here this also 1 is to 2, 1 is to 2, 1 is to 2. All the four sides are of the same ratio. But still, they are not similar because the corresponding angles are not equal. Here angle A is not equal to angle P. This is a rhombus, whereas this is a square. Square and rhombus are also not similar. Right? In the above figures, corresponding sides are equal. Corresponding sides are in the same ratio. But the corresponding angles are not equal, therefore they are not similar. You understand now, both the things are important. For two figures to be similar, if they are polygons, they should have same number of sides. First, corresponding angles must be equal, corresponding sides must be proportional. This is what we need. Next, we will go for exercise 6.1. Okay, this we just discussed yesterday. We'll look into this in detail. Fill in the blanks using correct word given in the brackets. All circles are congruent or similar?
Similar.
Similar.
We cannot say they are congruent. If the radius, radii, both the radius of one circle is equal to radius of another circle, we say they match each other. Okay? Therefore, in general, all circles are similar. Next, all squares are also similar.
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 Similar. Similar.
Similar. Said they are congruent. Next, all dashed triangles are similar. Equilateral triangles are similar.
Equilateral.
Here there are two blanks and two words in the end. Two polygons of the same number of sides are similar if their corresponding angles are proportional or equal.
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 Equal. And their corresponding sides are proportional.
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 Okay. Proportional. This is what the thing here is. Next, we can see the answers here. Similar, similar, equilateral, equal and proportional. Just a minute, children. Now we move on to the second problem of this exercise. Second problem of this exercise is, give two different examples of pair of similar figures, non-similar figures. Similar figures can be given here, two examples here, easy to tell that. Now see, similar figures, two equilateral triangles with side 2 centimeters and 4 centimeters. Example, two squares with 1 centimeter square, 2 centimeter square, they are also similar. Now, here we go, these are the equilateral triangles, 2 centimeter side here, 4 centimeter side here. They are similar because all the corresponding angles are equal, all the corresponding angles are equal and the corresponding sides are in the same ratio, 2 is to 4, 2 is to 4, 2 is to 4 all the time. Next, we have the squares here, squares here, 1 centimeter square, 2 centimeter square, the sides are proportional, therefore they are similar, right? Angles are automatically equal, all are 90 degree. Non-similar figures you can check here. Trapeziums, one trapezium and a square, they are non-similar, they are not similar. Okay, triangle and parallelogram also are not similar because they are now the very basic thing, number of sides are not equal here itself, that similarity will go. Here number of sides are equal but they are not of the same shape. For similarity, shape is important. For congruency, both the same, the shape as well as the size matters there. Size is not a matter at all in similarity. Next, question number 3. State whether the following quadrilaterals are similar or not. These are the quadrilaterals. Here if you observe, it is a parallelogram, it is a square. The corresponding sides are of the same ratio. 1.53, 1.53, 1.53, 1.53. The ratio of the corresponding sides are same. But the corresponding angles are not equal. Therefore, they are not similar. They are not similar. Not similar as their corresponding sides are proportional. But their corresponding angles are not equal. Basic proportionality theorem or Thales theorem. Why it is Thales theorem, I will tell you at a later stage. Let us talk about similarity of triangles quickly and come back to the theorem. Two triangles are similar if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are in the same ratio or in proportion. Okay? Now, this is what we already learned. Once again, we'll just a quick revision we'll give. If the corresponding angles of two triangles are equal, they are called equiangular triangles. What is the name of the triangles given? Equiangular triangles. Like equiangular polygons. Okay. Now, in two equiangular triangles, any two sides, the ratio of any two sides of any two corresponding sides in two equiangular triangles is always same. This was pronounced by Thales, and it is believed that Thales had used a result called basic proportionality theorem to prove this result. What was the result? The ratio of any two corresponding sides in two equilateral triangles is always the same. Equiangular triangles. Equiangular triangles means similar triangles. So this theorem is called Thales theorem. Basic proportionality theorem is also called Thales theorem because Thales had proved it using a particular result. Okay, this particular result. Now let us see this was Thales, and the theorem goes like this. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect other two sides in distinct points, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Okay, once again read the entire theorem once. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Now let us understand the theorem. We will actually verify it by actual measurement. Is it correct or not? Let us check that. So let us take a GeoGebra file here, in which I have drawn the triangle and actual measurements I made. Let me see. The GeoGebra file is starting. So once again, recollect the theorem. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, then the line divides the other two sides in the same ratio. This is what is the theorem here. Now here I have drawn a triangle. Able to see the triangle, all of you? Aishwarya, are you looking at the screen?
Yes sir.
Let us draw a line parallel to BC, and this is the line drawing I am drawing parallel to BC, and checking whether verifying whether the theorem is right or wrong by actual measurement. See, ADE is drawn parallel to BC. DE is drawn parallel to BC, and the measure of AD is 4.67. of course I measured it using the computer measurements here, and DB is 3.56 and the ratio is 1.31. similarly, AE by EC is also 1.31. you may ask me, sir, you fixed those, you have just drawn those. No, I can change the measurement. You can see, can you see, when I am holding one of the vertices of the triangle and moving this, the measures are changing, but still the ratio is remaining the same. You may ask me, why do you keep this DE here only? I can put it here also. Even then, the ratio is not changing. Could you see, all of you? Even when the position of line DE or line segment DE is changed, the ratio is not changed. Even when the measures of the triangle, sides of the triangle are changed, the same is the result. Now, will it happen to only this side, BC? No, it will happen to the other side also. You may see the same thing happening here also. A line segment is parallel to one of the sides and it is intersecting the other two sides in distinct points, different points. That means this point, this line should not be here. Somewhere over here, it should not be here near this point. Okay, it should be here somewhere. So then only it will be distinct. Even then, the result is not changing. Let us see for this line, for this particular side. Yes, even then, the same is the result. That means if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, it divides the other two sides in the same ratio. This is proved experimentally now. Now, you cannot prove this experimentally in the examination. Do you do like this in the exam? You cannot do all this demonstration. Therefore, you have to prove it logically or theoretically. So, let us prove the theorem logically. To prove the theorem logically, we need to have some important information with us. And we have to recollect some important information which we have already learned. Now let us see this one and this particular demonstration, and which will make us recollect the concepts what we have already learned, which are important to understand this theorem. Okay, now another GeoGebra file is starting, so I'll wait. Now tell me, can you tell me what is the area of a triangle? Harshita?
Half into base.
Half base into height.
Half base into height.
Half
base
into height. Half base into height. Half base into height.
Okay. Children, right. Now, I want Manasa to answer. Will you simply say height or any other word is there for that? Why do you say height and what is it? Manasa? Any problem with Manasa? Mavya can answer now. Mavya can answer. Do you say only height of a triangle or any other word is there for that?
Height is there.
What is the other word for height of a triangle? Actually,
altitude, sir.
Altitude, right. Good. It is altitude. It is simply say we say height in normal words, but it is actually altitude. Altitude is a perpendicular drawn from one of the vertices of the triangle to its opposite side. So here we take the triangle DEF. Now DEF I have drawn like this to have all the angles are acute here. Therefore DEF, triangle DEF is an acute angle triangle. Its altitude is in the interior now. Right? Now, if I make this triangle a right angle triangle, what is happening? One of the sides and altitude are becoming the same. It happens. Next, if the triangle is becoming an obtuse angle triangle, then the height or the altitude is falling in the exterior. So, altitude is a perpendicular drawn from a vertex to its opposite side or the line containing the opposite side. That's the actual definition of altitude. So, half of base multiplied by height or the altitude, the corresponding altitude, we must say the corresponding altitude to that particular base. For this base, this is the altitude. So, corresponding altitude multiplied by height, corresponding altitude multiplied to the particular base, which is halved to get the area of the triangle. Now, these two triangles have a special quality. Can anybody tell me what is the special quality of these triangles?
They are on the same base.
They are between
the same
pattern. Okay. Between the same pattern.
On the same base, between the
they
same
have areas. Same area.
All right.
There are same area also.
Very good. This is the theorem we learned in class 9. The triangles, both the triangles are on the same base DE and between the same parallels HI and GF. And therefore, we can say that the triangles have the same area. Now let us check whether the triangles have the same area or not. Of course, they will have because base is same and the altitude, corresponding altitude is also the same. Therefore, they have the triangle DEF, area of triangle DEF is 45.32 and triangle DEG also is 45.42. Do you agree with this one? Or will it happen for the same triangle, only for these triangles or any other triangle? Let us check that. See, I am changing the height. I am changing even the triangle, shape of the triangle is changed. Now, the base of the triangle also can be changed. Even then, the blue number and the red number, that is the area of the triangles, is the same here. Of course, I have used a formula here to get like this. Whenever these are changed, of course calculations will automatically change. See, now 6.19 is the height, base, and I want to change this height also. I will change like this. Even then, the triangles which are on the same base between the same parallels have the same area. So with this demonstration, you recollected this particular theorem, height of area of a triangle as well as area of the triangles also you learned. Areas of two triangles between the same, on the same parallel, between the same parallels and on the same base have the same area. You recollected these two. Now let us go back to our presentation. We'll have a theoretical proof. You cannot write like this in the examination. So you have to write using particular steps here for finding the area of finding the proof of the theorem. So for proving a theorem logically, we have 5 steps. We learned this in class 9. What are the 5 steps? Step 1, you have to write the statement and give the corresponding figure. Then step 2, you have to write what is given in mathematical terms, in logical terms. And step 3, if any construction is there to prove, you have to draw the construction. And lastly, that is step 5, you have to give the construction. Of course, in between by miss the step, that is what is required to prove, you have to write in mathematically, that is second step of course. So 5 steps are there. Let us now start with the statement and the correspond what is given and corresponding diagram we draw. Could you see now all of this? Nikita, is it happening on your
camera?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Triangle ABC, DE is drawn parallel to BC, and D and E are distinct points. Of course, it is intersecting at distinct points. So we need to prove, what we need to prove now here, let us understand that. To prove AD by DB is equal to AE by EC, we have to prove. For that, we need a construction also. What is that construction? We have to draw a perpendicular EN to AD. That means for this triangle, I am drawing a perpendicular taking base as AD from E. Okay? That will become the altitude for this triangle. Why should we take altitude this side only? We can take another way also. So I will draw a DM perpendicular to AE. If I take AE as the base, DM will become its altitude. Now I will join BE and CD. Thereby I get two more triangles here. Now I have got triangle ADE, one triangle on the top, and two triangles BDE and ECD on the other side. Okay, so two triangles also I have got on the bottom. So one triangle on the top, two triangles here. I can very well take the areas of these triangles in mathematical terms, of course not in numbers, I will take in the variables and compare the areas. I will try comparing. Actually I need the ratio between AD and DB. So AD is the base of this triangle, therefore I take the area of the triangle like this. Area of triangle ADE can be given in two different ways. By taking AD as the base, it is half AD multiplied by EN, and the same is given by AE multiplied by half AE multiplied by DM. You understand? Now let us take other two triangles also. Triangle BDE. BDE is an obtuse angle triangle, therefore its height or its altitude is falling in the exterior. See, this is EN itself is the altitude of triangle BDE. Yes, right? You may change even. See, it is perpendicular all the time. EN is perpendicular to the line containing BD, right? Now, and therefore its area is half BD into AN. Now you can take the area of triangle ECD also as half of EC multiplied by, what is the altitude for this? DM now. DM is the altitude. See, DM is the altitude for this triangle. you can see this one, dm. Are you observing? So dm is the altitude for this triangle if you take EC as the base. Okay, you may ask me, why are you taking BD and EC as bases for this? You can take very well BDE as the base. But what is to be proved, you have to keep in mind. I want BD here in the denominator. Here I want EC in the denominator. Therefore, I am choosing those particular sides are the base, are the as the basis for these triangles. Now, very well, we can say area of the same triangle. These two are the areas of the same triangles of two different, in two different ways we gave, but still they can be equated. They are equal. They are equal. That is understood. Now, what about triangle BDE and ECD? They are on the same base between the same parallels. Therefore, their areas are equal. They are on the same base DE between the same parallels DE and BC. Therefore, their areas are equal. Now, we can take the ratio between these two, ADE and BDE. If I take ADE and BDE, okay, but that is one ratio. And if I take ADE and ECD, that is another ratio. Since ADE is the same triangle, BDE and ECD are having the equal area, that means the ratios also will be equal. Do you agree with this or not?
Yes, sir.
Ratio of area of triangle ADE and BDE, ratio of triangle ADE and ECD will be the same. So, I can write an equation like this. Area ADE divided by area DBE is same as the area of triangle ADE by area of triangle ECD. Then, for instead of these, I will put these RHS, whatever on the right hand side of each of these areas I will put now. I will mark these like this. AD, half ADA, what is area ADE? Half AD into EN. And what is a BDE, that is DBE, half DB into EN. Very well, half is a common factor, can be cancelled. EN is also common in both denominator and numerator, you can cancel. Here also, DM is a common factor, can be cancelled, half can be cancelled. So, we are left with the what is the proof required now. You can very well see this. AD by DB is equal to AC by AE by EC. We proved the theorem. Did we prove or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
This is what is exactly you have to write. What exactly you have to write in the
exam.
If it comes in the exam, you have to write all these steps. Okay? Did you understand here? So I will go back to the normal screen again. Once quickly you note down or take a screenshot to note down at a later stage, theorem we are going to prove. Proved by Thales. Actually, he used this result to prove that in two similar triangles, the ratio of any two corresponding sides is the same. To prove that, he has used this result. Therefore, it is also called Thales' theorem. Okay? To prove this theorem also here, we have taken different triangles and the ratio of areas of the triangles we have. Exercise 6.2, question number 1. In the following figures, DE dash DE is parallel to BC. Find EC in figure 1, AD in figure 2. There are two figures here. This is the textbook question as well. All these textbook questions only, you can very well understand them. DE is given parallel to BC. And the parts are given here, AD, DB, AE, BC. By basic proportionality theorem, you can very well write one relation between these parts of the sides, like AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Okay? It divides in the same ratio. Therefore, what is AD? Whatever is given, you substitute now. AD equal to 1.5, DB equal to 3. And AE equal to 1, EC equal to not known. EC, let it be X now. Now cross multiplication. 3 into 1 equal to 1.5 into X. So 3 into 1 is divided by 1.5 to get what is the value of X. 1.5, 2 times it will divide 3. So EC is equal to 2. This is the answer here. Now let us consider the second question. Given that DE is parallel to BC, therefore AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Same. Whatever is given, we will substitute. And remaining, whatever is not given, for that we will think it is X here, we will think X. Therefore, X by 7.2 is equal to 1.8 by 5.4. So, this 7.2 is to be sent that side to get the value of X. X equal to 1.8 into 7.2 by 5.4. So, when you think that there is no point here for these two, 18, 54. 18 threes are 54. Now by 3, if you divide this one, 3, 24s are 72. Because there is a point here, I have to write 2.4. So AD equal to 2.4. E and F are the points on the sides PQ and PR respectively of triangle PQR. For each of the following cases, state whether EF is parallel to QR or not. Here the related figure is not given. We have to do it on our own. Three pictures are given here, but we will only, I'll take up only two questions here. One question I'll leave it for your understanding. Okay? Now, the question is here. PE equal to 3.9, EQ equal to 3, PF is this much, FR is this much. Let us draw the related figure for the first one. PQR is the triangle. EF is drawn a line. Of course, we don't know whether it is parallel or not. So, EF is drawn just to intersect PQ and PR. And the measurements, whatever they have given, I substituted there in the figure. I placed in the figure here. PE by and PE, EQ, PF and FR. And I will take the ratios of PE by EQ, PF by FR. These ratios, if they are equal, we can prove that EF is parallel to QR. Otherwise, no. Let us take the ratios. PE by EQ is equal to 3.9 by 3, that is 1.3. 3 thirteens, because the decimal place is there, so 1.3. PF by FR is 3.6 by 2.4. It is actually, you can take 12 table here, 12 2s, 12 3s, 3 by 2 you get, 3 by 2 means again 1.5. And these ratios are not same. The values here, PE by EQ is not equal to PF by FR. Therefore, EF is not parallel to QR. Let's take the second case also and check. E and F are the points on the sides. Again, the same question. The second one we are looking into. PE is 4, EQ is 4.5, PF is 8 and FR is 9. Observe here children, here 4 is doubled here, 4 2s are 8. 4.5 also when you double, you will get 9. Is it not? That means the ratios are equal. That is understood. Therefore, let me see again practically here. PE by EQ, instead of dividing, what did I do? I multiplied by 2 here. So, I am getting 8.9, which can be easily equated to the other one. So, the ratios are equal. Therefore, this line EF is parallel to QR. That is the second. Now, here is the question. In the following figure, LM parallel CB, LN parallel CD. Prove that AM by AB is equal to AN by AD. Here is the picture given or figure given here. A triangle here, A, C, B or ABC one triangle, ADC is another triangle. A, B, C, this is one triangle, the other one is other triangle. In this triangle we will see this line is parallel to this line. That is given, LM is parallel to CB. Therefore, we can very well write a relation between the parts of the sides like this. AM by AB. Now, I told you in the beginning, AM by AB we can write is equal to AL by AC also we can write. Okay, by BPT, basic proportionality theorem. Now the same thing you can write in this triangle, considering this triangle ADC or ACD, because LN is parallel to CD, we can write AN by AD is equal to AL by AC. In 1 and 2, if you see, observe, the right hand sides are equal. The right hand sides are equal. See here, the right hand side AL by AC, here also AL by AC. Therefore, we can equate the left hand sides. What are the left hand sides? AM by AB equal to AN by AD. That is what is to be proved, and we proved it. Agreed? Yeah, I am moving. Yeah, moving on to the fourth one now. Fourth one. In this also, the same is the case almost. Here is a triangle ABC, and by drawing lines DF and AE, ABE, another triangle is formed. Say DE is parallel to AC. DE, what is DE here? This is DE. DE is parallel to AC. This is the line. So you have to consider the big triangle, and we can write, very well write, BD by AD is equal to BE by EC. Okay? Like this we can write one statement. Also given that DF is parallel to this one, DF, I am drawing a line in reverse, of course two arrow marks on this one in reverse. These two are parallel. So for triangle ABE also we can write a statement using BPT. In triangle ABC, DE parallel AC, therefore BD by DA is equal to BE by EC. This is the first statement. Next one, in triangle BAE, we can say BD by DA or AD is equal to BE by FE. So it is not FE, it is BF by FE. It is not BE, BF by FE. Now again you compare these two statements. Right, left hand sides are equal here. So we have to equate the right hand sides. BE by EC equal to BF by FE. Only three statements here also. Right? Very important. Now, hereafter the questions are important. Question number 5 onwards, questions are important. So now, of course, I change the color here for this particular pen. This one, question. Now, here you see DE is parallel to OQ. This is what is DE. DE, line DE is parallel to OQ. So you consider this triangle PQO or POQ. Then by basic proportionality theorem we can write PE by EQ equal to PD by DO. Next, they have given DF is parallel to OR. Therefore we can write PD by DO is equal to PF by FR, you can write. So let us write those two statements. In POQ, DE parallel OQ, therefore PE by EQ equal to PD by DO. Then in triangle POR, DF parallel OR, that is given, therefore PF by FR equal to PD by DO. So in these two statements we have same RHS, therefore LHS are to be equated. We are equating the LHS here. Of course these two are happening because of BPT. So PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. So now we will use the converse of BPT and say, since the ratios, since a line segment drawn is dividing the other two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, that is parallel to the third side. Third side, what is the third side here? It is QR. So this is now what is given is, given that PE, this one by this one, EQ, is equal to PF by this one is given. Of course, I should not draw lines like this. If I draw in mathematical terms, they are equal. This is for equality we are writing. I am just showing this. I am marking them to understand. So PE by EQ is given as PF by FR by this statement. That means this line EF is dividing the two sides of the triangle, big triangle, in the same ratio. That means this line is parallel to QR. That's all. So that is by converse of basic proportional theorem. Question 6 also is the same thing. Let us understand that here. It is rather easier than question 5. Now you see, PQR is a triangle. ABC is another triangle drawn in the interior. And two parallels are given. AB parallel PQ. AB is parallel to PQ. AC is parallel to PR. We have to prove that BC is parallel to QR. Of course, same way we proceed as we did in case in question number 5, we proceed in the same way. Say that in triangle POQ, since AB parallel PQ, OA by AB is equal to OB by BQ, and in triangle POR, the other triangle, this side triangle I am taking, POR, this one. So in this triangle, this is parallel to this one, therefore again OA by PA or AP is equal to OC by CR. Again we can very well check that the left hand sides are equal, therefore right hand sides are equated. OB by BQ equal to OC by CR. Once OB by CQ BQ is equal to OC by CR, that means this line segment BC is dividing that sides OQ and OR of triangle OQR in the same ratio. That means this is parallel to this one by basic proportionality theorem. Converse of basic proportionality theorem. Okay, BPT is converse, we are proving it. Right? So BPT is used and converse also is used. Therefore, question number 5 and 6 are important. They may come anywhere in any exam. So be ready. Next question here, that is question number 9. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB parallel DC and its diagonals intersect each other at O. Show that AO by BO is equal to CO by DO. To prove that we will draw, oh my god, we draw the particular trapezium ABCD, and then in this trapezium again, in this trapezium, given that AB is parallel, this is parallel to this side DC, and we have to these two are the diagonals, they bisect each other, they intersect each other at O. To prove that AO is AO by BO is equal to CO by DO, we draw a line here EF parallel to DC passing through this particular point of intersection. When EF is parallel to DC, it is also parallel to E. All three lines are parallel, that you think, that you keep in mind now. Now, after drawing this one, after drawing like this, you can check EO is parallel to CD. EO, now this part EO is parallel to CD. Therefore, AE by DC, ED is equal to AO by OC. This is the first one. Now, in triangle ABD, OE is parallel to AB also. Okay, because of the parallel lines property, and very well we can write ED by AE is equal to DO by OD by BO, or DO by BO, and you can very well interpret like this in reverse you can say AE by ED is equal to BO by OD. And in 1 and 2, equations 1 and 2, left hand sides are equal. We have to make the right hand sides equal here like this. AO by OC is equal to BO by OD. And cross multiply them. Here, AO into OD is equal to AO into OD is equal to, or AO into DO, I'll write, that is better. OD or DO both are same line segment. On cross multiplication, it is happening. Next, BO into DO. It is equal to BO into DO. BO into DO. Then, we can very well bring AO, BO down AO. That means AO by BO is equal to CO by DO. That's all. This manipulation we have to write at the end. Now, very well we proved the 9th one very easily. Now just 1 more minute children, I will finish the 10th one also so that this exercise can be completed. Now in 10th one, this ratio is given. This ratio is given. We have to prove that it is a trapezium. If it happens in a particular quadrilateral, prove that that quadrilateral is a trapezium. Now let's move on to the question and read that. The diagonals of quadrilateral ABCD intersect each other at point O, and AO by BO equal to CO by DO. Actually that is the result of the last one. The result is given now. We have to prove that it's a trapezium. That means it is like converse of converse BBT and converse question number 9 and question number 10. They are converse of each other. Now we have drawn the figure again like this. Here also you need to draw EO parallel to AB or OE parallel to AB. Then take this AO by BO again, and just like in the say this one, you write in this fashion first. From this one we are bringing it reverse to this one. AO by OC is equal to AO by, now of course we will write that one at a later stage. See here, ABD we are taking, ABD, when we take AE by, this is parallel to AB, it is drawn now, AE by ED, this by this is equal to BO by OD. Next, AO by OC, however it is given that AO by OC, that means here we manipulated that way, AO by CO is equal to BO by DO, it is given, these two are equal, okay. Therefore, when we know this one, equations 1 and 2 you can check, AE by this one also we can write, these two are equal here, BO by OD, BO by OD. Therefore, these two are equated now. The left hand sides are equated. AE by ED is equal to AO by OC. AE by ED is equal to AO by OC. That means you take this triangle now. This triangle you take now. In this line EO is dividing the other two sides in the same ratio. AE by ED is equal to AO by CO, meaning AO is, or EO is parallel to CD also. Firstly, we know that this OE is parallel to AB, and this same line is parallel to CD also. Therefore, AB and CD are parallels. Therefore, ABCD is a trapezium. If two sides are parallel in a quadrilateral, that becomes a trapezium. So with this, we completed the exercise.